Good morning, everyone, and thank you so much for joining our presentation today. DrChrono is very excited to have 100 plus speaking today about remote patient monitoring one-on-one. And so they will be leading this presentation. But before we actually do start, we're gonna wait about 3 or 4 minutes here to give some more attendees the ability to log on. So until then, just hold on tight and thank you so much for your time today. All right, so we have hit 2:05, so or 11:05 PST. So I'll go ahead and get started. Thank you guys once again for joining this presentation today. We're going to be discussing remote patient monitoring one-on-one. And before we officially start, there are some items that I wanted to mention. If you do have any questions during this webinar, feel free to use our chat and type those questions in. We will have a QA session towards the end where we'll go ahead and address every question that has been typed out. So feel free. We are excited to hear from you and we'll love to answer any questions that you do have. So with further ado, we're gonna go ahead and go on to the next slide and we're going to introduce our official speakers here, two amazing people from 100 Plus. We have David Sloan, who is the Director of Sales, and we also have Cole Jordan, who is the Senior Account Executive. So I'm going to stop talking and I'm going to let them go ahead and take over. Thank you guys so much for speaking and take it away.
Thanks so much, Juliet. Appreciate everyone attending today and to learn more about remote patient monitoring. My name's Dave. I head up the sales team over here. And then Cole will be leading the majority of the conversation here. He's one of our most senior and tenured account executives on the team. He's heard most of the questions and has the answers to most of them. So excited to walk through remote patient monitoring with everyone today. And I'll turn it over to Cole here.
Yeah, thanks, Dave. Certainly thank you for your time today here, everyone. Before we dive in, I wanted to see, how familiar are you with remote patient monitoring? Excellent. So happy to clarify some things here. For a brief agenda, we'll be discussing what remote patient monitoring is as a whole. We'll be going into how an RPM platform works, the barriers that really need to be overcome to get up and running, decision criteria for choosing a remote patient monitoring platform, the reimbursements that Medicare will pay, and then we'll discuss the overall economics of what remote patient monitoring means for your practice. So what is remote patient monitoring, right? Just the 10,000 foot view from Medicare here is that it's a new platform really looking to reduce the rates of hospital readmission. Medicare is paying an exorbitant amount of money year over year just for hospital readmission rates. So that's why they're actually incentivizing providers here to remotely monitor conditions such as diabetes, CHF, and hypertension to ultimately keep patients out of the emergency room. So by enabling clinicians such as yourself to identify these conditions before they become potentially life-threatening, as I mentioned, Medicare is really looking to keep patients out of the emergency room. They've also stated that it's going to be at no cost to Medicare patients who have at least one chronic condition that really needs to be monitored on an ongoing basis. And with Medicare being the most predictable payer in the United States, you know that you're going to receive the reimbursement for the time that you do spend. So at the end of the day, how does a remote patient monitoring platform work? So to get started, obviously you have to enroll, and so do your patients. With that comes patient consent to be able to remotely transmit their data. And after that, the devices are then shipped directly to the patient. Following the patients use the devices, and then you automatically start receiving those readings as soon as they start using the devices so that you can start seeing those clinical results in real time. And obviously, time is money. So once that time has been spent, You just bill Medicare for the reimbursement, and they'll cover all of the costs associated for remote patient monitoring.
I think one of the keys here is in any good RPM platform is that when something does test out of range from your patients, that you do receive an alert so that you're obviously alerted to that abnormal test, but then also directed directly to the patient's file within the portal so that you can review the results and act accordingly.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Thanks, Dave. And roadblocks. Obviously, starting a new program always has a few roadblocks to get up and running. As I'm sure you know, the Medicare population is not always the most tech savvy. I mean, just speaking from experience, I think that myself, my mother, my father are on the phone with my grandmother at least once a day, just trying to get her logged into email. And with that, some solutions for remote patient monitoring will actually require manual data entry, which is obviously going to create additional barriers when a patient does test their vitals. The question then comes up between the patient and provider, oh, you know, I did the test, but I must have forgot to submit it. So that can always be a barrier with actually receiving the patient's vitals. And with that as well, with only 60% of the Medicare population actually having an internet connection within the home, remote patient monitoring needs to have the ability to encompass the entire Medicare population. And some platforms will require the setup with Bluetooth or connectivity with an app on a smartphone as well. And then lastly, starting new programs always has a financial risk obligated. So some providers or some RPM providers will require an upfront payment for the devices. It will sometimes lock you into an ongoing contract as well. Some other factors to consider here. You're a medical practice, not a warehouse. So some vendors will require inventory management when you do purchase those devices upfront. And with that comes the human resources and capital required to both maintain that inventory as well as monitor the patient's vitals and follow up with them to make sure that they're using the devices. Lastly, the question comes up, who's actually going to enroll the patients? Who's going to contact them to get set up and educated? Will that have to be myself, or is the company that I'm working with going to do that? Some vendors will handle that work, and some will put it on your plate so that you have to do all of the manual work to input the patients into the system. And when it comes to making a decision when selecting a remote patient monitoring platform, there's obviously going to be a few decision criteria that it really comes down to. The first one being risk. Is there a risk associated with signing up with this company, whether it be upfront or ongoing, both for you yourself and for your patients? And with that comes which devices and which conditions am I going to be able to use those devices to monitor?
I think one of the things to add there is how many devices can I assign to a patient to monitor all of their conditions, or am I limited by anything such as like you can only use two devices on a patient with some platforms?
Exactly. And another thing to note here is how much time am I going to have to spend? Who's going to spend that time? And ultimately, as you know, time is money. So the question comes up, is my clinical staff going to be responsible for maintaining the system, or is the vendor that I'm going to be working with going to manage all of the additional work outside of actually remotely monitoring patients' vitals? And then lastly, the support comes into question. Who's going to handle the support if a patient needs batteries replaced in their devices, if their device isn't transmitting data, whether or not it's just a simple 10 patients or all the way up to 10,000 patients? And lastly, it's obviously going to be critical, as Dave mentioned, to know what's happening with your patients in real time. So alerts are absolutely critical when it comes to population health management, following up with your patients in real time so that they can stay out of the emergency room. And before I dive in here, how familiar is everyone with the CPT codes and the reimbursements as put forth by Medicare? Well, excellent. Certainly happy to clarify everything here. And it's great to see that some people are familiar with the CPT codes here. To start off, we'll start with 99453. And one thing to note is that these dollar figures are the national averages for reimbursement. And as I'm sure you know, Medicare does reimburse based on locality. So these figures do vary. Starting off with the first one, 99453. 99453 covers getting a patient set up and ultimately using the platform. So it's billed once during the patient's lifetime. The next three codes are all monthly, where 99454 covers the cost of all of the remote patient monitoring devices and the services that are rendered on the back end as well. Then 99457 and 99458 cover the reimbursement for the time that you spend utilizing remote patient monitoring data. So 99457 will cover the first 20 minutes spent throughout the calendar month, and 99458 will cover an additional 40 minutes as billed in 20-minute increments. So the ultimate revenue potential, if all of these codes are billed and a total of 60 minutes has been spent with the patient throughout the month, is $198, as a national average. But obviously there's going to be some costs associated with using remote patient monitoring. So this table here details our service fee, which will vary somewhat, again, because Medicare reimburses based on location. Here, the national average is a nice round $49.95, bringing the annual yearly revenue potential per practice or per patient to $136. So that's obviously if all codes are billed and a total of 60 minutes has been spent with the patient throughout the month with 99458. Billed twice. Now that's not going to be the case for every single patient. So let's take a look at a more conservative estimate of what your practice will make by utilizing remote patient monitoring. So you'll see here, this is with our service fee removed and with 99458 removed as well. So this is definitely on the conservative end if the minimum of 20 minutes has been spent with the patient throughout the month. Looking at 50 patients, the annual yearly net revenue is around $40,000. All the way up to 800 patients, where the annual yearly net revenue is over $600,000 that you're collecting as an impact towards your bottom line. So we've discussed quite a few things here in terms of remote patient monitoring as a whole and the economics involved with the program over time. Now, where does 100 Plus fit into the picture? We offer our program at no upfront cost to providers. And to decrease the administrative time that your practice has to spend, we handle that through white glove onboarding, where our customer success team does all of that administrative work, such as inputting the patients into the system, filling out those boxes of patient information that I'm sure you've seen 1,000 times, as well as contacting the patients to get the consent and educate them to get set up. Time is always money, as I mentioned. So the ability to scale rapidly is certainly contained within our program. And then for your patients, there's not going to be any cost for the patients themselves. We cover up to 5 devices per patient, cover the shipping as well as replacement in the case that the devices break. When it comes to actually transmitting those patients' vitals, all of our devices are cell enabled and they're pre-configured when we ship them directly to a patient's home. So they don't need to do any sort of additional setup. They don't need any additional devices like a smartphone or computer. On top of that, some of the devices require consumables, the blood glucose meter specifically. And as a diabetic myself, I can certainly understand the challenges faced when you run out of test strips. I mean, I've gone to the pharmacy before in a complete fire drill after I ran out myself. They're completely out of stock and I was left with nothing to test with. So with that being said, we cover all of those test strips and lancets, ship them directly to a patient and refill them automatically, based upon the amount of times per day that they're testing their blood sugar.
Yeah, as batteries wear out, we'll obviously take care of that too. And from time to time, right, there's a slip up with a device and it breaks, right? It's dropped or run over with a car, whatever the case may be. Devices are replaced at no additional cost ever as well.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, we certainly understand that, you know, things come up. As Dave mentioned, patients may drop a device. There may be issues with the devices transmitting data. And our team is here to help with that and replace the devices in the case that the need is there. Certainly, not frequent. And then let me tell you a little story here about one of the providers that we work with. So Dr. Liberoni faced a couple of issues that I'm sure are present in your practice as well, in terms of treating his senior population with chronic conditions. And he wanted to get up and running very quickly. So by removing those barriers to enrollment and onboarding, he found that remote patient monitoring 100 plus was really his eyes and boots in the house with the patients that he was working with. I don't need to read the quote here to bore you here, but you can certainly see that he was a fan of the program as well. And then, if you'd like to learn some more about the program, during the month of October, to meet with myself or another member of my team, we are offering $50 for completing a demonstration here. And if you want to get up and running, we are offering $500 for activating a 100 plus account until the end of October. So I know that was a lot of information all at once. I would like to open up the floor to any questions that I may be able to address here.
All right. Thank you so much. And I see that we do have a question here that was posted. It was a certificate. I don't believe there's a certificate of attendance for this webinar. Just attending it. I don't believe so, Joseph. Let's see. I do have another question here. The question was, are you integrated with DrChrono?
As of now, we are not integrated with DrChrono. I think Dave may be able to touch upon the current roadmap for direct integration. However, we are going to be utilizing DrChrono's direct billing here in the next 2 months as well. Dave, do you have anything to elaborate there in terms of the integration?
Yeah, we are still working with both the 100 plus team and the DrChrono team to map out what that looks like. So that should be coming in the future. I would guess sometime next year.
Okay. All right. And feel free to type in any other questions that anyone may have. Let's see. I have another question here. Can I enroll non-Medicare patients?
Not currently. We do work with Medicare Advantage patients. So if you have patients who are on Medicare Advantage or Medicare replacement plans offered through private payers, we can certainly work with those as well. However, private insurance strictly isn't necessarily reimbursing consistently for remote patient monitoring, which is why we're really focused on the Medicare population.
Right. Let's see. I have another question. Who handles billing?
So that's currently handled within the practice, just as your biller would be submitting for the CPT codes for reimbursement that they already are. We do simplify the process and help generate the claims as you use the platform. And as I mentioned, we're going to be rolling out the direct billing in the next 2 months here. In that case, we'll be billing Medicare directly for the reimbursement and then debiting the account that's on file minus our service fee.
All right. Let's see. Question here. What happens if a patient no longer wishes to be a part of your program or on the program?
Great question. So if a patient is disenrolls, moves to a different provider, or in the worst case, passes on, we then deactivate the cell service and shut down their profile on 100 plus. If the devices are used, they're then the patients to keep. However, if the devices are unused, they haven't been taken out of the box and used by the patient whatsoever, we will request for the devices to be returned in that case.
Okay, and I have a question here. What are the exact rules around who can do the monitoring?
So any sort of qualified clinical staff within the practice can conduct the monitoring itself, whether it be the physician, physician's assistant, nurse practitioners, or clinical nurses as well.
Okay, and let's see, does anybody else have any other questions for the 100 plus team regarding the product, any questions about remote patient monitoring? Feel free to type in your questions in the chat. I'll give you guys about a minute here to type in your questions. And while you guys are doing that, just so you know, This is being recorded, so everyone who has attended this webinar today will receive a copy of this recording and a follow-up email from DrChrono, so be on the lookout for that. Does anybody have any other questions that they're typing in before we close for today? I'll just wait a couple of seconds here before I close. And they do have their contact as well, as you can see here, in case you do think of any questions later on that you may have, you know, not thought about before. Feel free to reach out to them directly here, and they will be more than happy to also answer those questions there. All right, doesn't look like we have any other questions. So thank you guys so much once again for attending. You will receive a follow-up email from DrChrono with the recording. And if that's it, thank you guys so much and have a great rest of your day.
Thanks for your time, everyone.
All right, thank you.
It was an absolute pleasure.